Hey, John, welcome to DevOps Driving. Great to have you on the show. Can you talk a little bit about your experience testing mobile application software?
Right. I'm a recovering Solaris administrator. I've spent most of my 20-year career in what I would call QA adjacent roles. When I came to testing, it gave me this very unique perspective on how everybody else does business, and then seeing this group of people who kind of bridge the gap, if you will, between, you know, development and operations and a lot of these other organizations. It was really, really fun for me to get involved with this. Last year, we acquired a couple of companies and had some new technology come out specifically around the mobile space. And that's how I got involved in the mobile world from a QA perspective.
John, people are using their mobile devices more than ever. So what is the mindset for testing mobile application software? Is it the same as testing traditional software? What's the same and what's different?
The traditional way to test software is that we're going to write some automation, and then we're going to run that automation on a bunch of different systems in parallel so we can get lots of testing done. Now, what's interesting about those systems that we're running in parallel is they're all the same. We design the system under test to be the exact same, and we replicate that across, you know, how many ever agent machines that you want to have. But we always have the same RAM. We have the same operating system, the same application installed, the same hard drive space, the same network connectivity. And we do that because in traditional software testing, we are looking to create stability in the system under test. When you test things on a mobile device, that all goes out the window. You have zero control over the system under test, because the system under test might be a cell phone from 5 years ago. It might be an Android. It might be an iOS. It might be a version of Android that is customized by some other company. You might have, even in newer phones, you get releases where you have different processors and different RAM capacities and all of these sorts of things. And so when you test on a mobile device, suddenly not only is the system under test different across the board, but we actually care about the system under test. We actually need to know whether or not our application performs well on the newest Samsung Galaxy phone or one from 2 or 3 years ago, right? The biggest phone or the smallest phone. You have massive resolution differences between phone sizes. So you'll have a release in the S22 will have, you know, a small phone that has a certain resolution, and then the big one that has a completely different resolution. And even though they're the same company and the same series of phones, you can't treat those things the same. And you have to understand that there are going to be millions of these devices on the market of all different shapes and sizes. And so the system under test starts to really matter when we think about mobile testing in general.
When you're setting up a test lab, you could set up physical devices, or you could set up virtual devices, or a combination of the two. Which one's better? Do you need both? And can you talk a little bit about the strengths and weaknesses of each?
So absolutely, there's a difference between physical devices, virtual devices. You absolutely need to have both. And I would even argue that you need on-prem devices as well for certain things. So the question becomes, do I want to maintain my own lab on-premise, or do I want to go the cloud route and have somebody else maintain it for me? I think when it comes to ease of use, and not only ease of use, but keeping things up to date, going the cloud route is definitely where it's at. If you have esoteric devices, if you have hand scanners or things that are custom to your organization that are not the traditional devices that would be found in the cloud, or if you have devices that you actually need to physically scan something or physically push a button on it in order to complete your test, then you're going to need to have some on-premise devices. Like you're going to have that. And that's not bad, because a lot of those very esoteric devices stick around for a really long time. The middle ground here is virtualized devices. And virtualized devices have a place, one, because they're way cheaper than physical devices, either on-prem or in the cloud. And the other reason is because they're faster. So you're not waiting for a real physical device to become available. You're just emulating, if you will, that device existing. And so it's cheaper, it's faster, you can do rapid iteration on that, and it gets you down the road much, much quicker.
So if you're a company thinking about starting this journey of mobile application testing, there might be a concern about complexity. A lot of different devices, a lot of hybrid situations, cross-platform testing. It could get overwhelming. So are there any sound practices that you can apply across mobile application testing?
Yeah, so the nice thing about that is that your standard best practices in the testing world tend to be your standard best practices in the mobile world as well. And fortunately for us, all of these things are integrated into Testem. And so you don't have to change the way that you do business or use some new application in order to do this. It's the same pipelines, it's the same integrations, it's the same way of doing business.
Can you give me an example of a success story where a company had to be mobile first and apply their testing of mobile apps to the DevOps operating model?
So one of our clients out in Australia is, they have a directive that they are going to be a cloud first company. And what came along with that is that most of their users were using their mobile app. That's how most of the people were interacting with their system. And so they had to be able to test and sort of load test, if you will, across 10,000 or so iOS devices. And they needed to be able to do this exceedingly rapidly because the cloud first initiative to them meant, okay, now we're doing infrastructure automation. Now we're doing CI/CD pipelines. We're really trying to adopt the DevOps flow. And so they didn't have time to wait on a legacy waterfall way of doing things. They ended up using a combination of virtual and physical devices to kind of manage what devices would be available. They integrated it directly into their testing pipelines. And what they saw was about a 66% increase in the speed of their release. And so because they could get through their testing so much faster, they then found, okay, now we can run some more tests that we didn't have time to before. And now we can iterate. Maybe we'll get an extra release in because we're releasing a little bit faster here and we're able to run some more tests. And so what that ended up doing for them was improving the overall quality of their release to the point where they were getting almost one extra release every single time.